G'day folks, it's Alistair with Mango's Mapping with you once again. Today I'm here with Jake Hartwig from Custom Mining Solutions, and we're down in the bottom of the pit at Kanmantoo Copper Mine in the Adelaide Hills. Custom Mining Solutions have been innovating a solution to the challenges in operating around voids. Can you tell the viewers at home a little bit more about what voids are and where they come from?
So in mining, we're taking out the material from a certain area, which leaves us with a cavity or an open void. It's just a dangerous section. Back in 2020, there was a mining incident that I was involved in search and rescue for, partly to do with the open void. Got me thinking, you know, what else can we do to improve safety around open voids? Yeah, it really gave me motivation to start pushing in to create this and to finish it off.
So Jake, if I understand it properly, there are occasions where people need to work around voids. What sort of safety practices are in place at the moment to determine that it's safe to be around a void?
So the current solutions are quite manual and prone to human error. The void monitor is a way around that, takes out that human error factor. So the void monitor can be set up at an open pit environment, underground environment, anywhere that leads up to an edge. So the LiDAR scanner essentially scans the back of the cliff. It's got a field of view that it's looking at from what we can't see. The void monitor uses a Ouster LiDAR scanning puck transmitted through to a junction box and then through to a traffic light system. It's up there constantly scanning. It takes out a lot of the human error. A good way to, you know, to know your area is safe all the time.
So operating 24/7, this thing works, you know, day and night. There is no real difference underground because it's a LiDAR sensor. It's using its own light, effectively the lasers generated by the sensor. So this is a 128 channel laser sensor you've got here, and it's generating around about 1.6 million laser pulses per second, which translates to about 1.6 million three-dimensional measurements per second. The magic in what you've done here is to simplify that down to a traffic light. What's the magic that happens between this incredibly sophisticated sensor and the really intuitive user interface, the traffic lights at the other end?
The LiDAR unit feeds the data straight through to the junction box where the smarts are. Dr. Damo from Beer, he's done all the coding and stuff for us, which has enabled us to be able to take that raw data, convert it into a user-friendly interface for the traffic light system to interpret.
What exactly do those different lights indicate for the end users in the mine?
So the void monitor's traffic light system is made up of three main functions. The green light represents that the area is structurally safe, intact, and is safe to proceed. The amber light represents a high material level, meaning that the area has filled up to its capacity. The amber light also has a built-in function that allows the LiDAR scanner to decipher between a machine and the material itself. While a machine is present, the amber light will intermittently flash until the machine has left the field of view, and then it will change back to a solid green. The red light represents something is missing from the field of view, indicating fall of ground, structurally unsafe, and the area is not safe to proceed.
The other high-tech, you know, LiDAR-based solutions that do scanning require highly trained people to come and operate those sensors and to interpret the data to report back to personnel in the mine. Does this system then allow anyone that's in proximity of the mine void to understand exactly what's going on?
Yeah, that's correct. So any user throughout the mine from any department, whether they're coming to tip or coming to a job around the open void, they can quite simply look at the traffic light, see what the situation is, and proceed from there.
Great. And Custom Mining Solutions take safety really seriously. Jake, can you tell us about some of the unique design aspects of your void monitor that contribute to the safety of the solution itself and some of the innovative materials that you've used?
We had to be able to design a device that could be installed from behind the 3 meter exclusion zone, but yet still have the reach to get out and to capture that field of view. So what we've got now is quite easy to wind up. You can do it with one hand.
A system that's intended to be durable, safe, easy to operate, and easy to interpret. It's also a relatively low-cost solution. I just wanted to point out to the viewers at home that this is just a demonstration site for people to be able to understand the technology and for personnel like ourselves to be able to come here and to be able to capture some additional information about it.
So we're going to start going into a early adopters program and try and get it into an underground environment where it traditionally would be used. The big thing for me with the void monitor is the safety aspect of it. I'd love to see the void monitor throughout the world improving safety in mining industries.
Oh, a gust of wind has just come through and given Jake and me a free shower. Well, Jake, thank you very much for your time showing us your demonstration solution today. I wish you all the best and we look forward to working with you in the future.
No worries, thank you very much.
So folks, if you've liked the video today, please feel free to hit the like button, to subscribe to our channel, and if you're interested to know more, please feel free to leave a comment in the questions below and we'll aim to get back to you. And we look forward to seeing you with our next videos.